Today's interview is with Vladimir Oane, one of the most well-known technology entrepreneurs in Romania. He was awarded by Forbes magazine at their 30 Under 30 Gala for the evolution of UberView, the startup he founded back in 2008. It was one of the first all-in-one social media services, and in 2014 had a spectacular exit being acquired by Hootsuite. Vladimir is now the director of product at Hootsuite. We ask Vladimir, what's your favorite book and why? Business and non-business, if possible. To which he replied, I'm not sure I can point to an all-time favorite. There are so many amazing books out there. But since you want only one, I'll give it a try. I will pick Jules Verne's Mysterious Island for a non-business favorite. I don't claim this is the best book out there, not even in its category, whatever that is. But I adored this book as a young boy. I remember that the night when I was approaching the end of the book, a power outage happened, and I finished reading it with the help of a candlelight. I love this book that much. Jules Verne introduced a world full of mysteries, with challenges that seem insurmountable, but with heroes that always find ingenious ways to overcome them using science and strength of character. It is also part of the universe, building on some of the reveals from the 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea or In Search of the Castaways. Maybe your readers shouldn't rush and grab this one unless they are 14 years old or deeply into steampunk adventure stories. But it meant a lot to me at that time. Maybe it sparked my interest in sciences or cultivated my sense of adventure. As for a business book, I would probably go with Clayton Christensen's Innovator's Dilemma. Clayton's book not only defined a disruption, a word that is still abused by journalists to this date, but it introduced me to strategic thinking. When I read the book, I probably missed a lot of the nuances around corporate politics, as I barely had any work or life experiences. But I keep rereading it from time to time and always find new insights. We ask Vladimir, was there a moment specifically when something you read in a book helped you? Can you tell us about it? He answered, let's take the book from above, Clayton Christensen's Innovator's Dilemma. I can say I didn't have a lot of business experience when I read the book, so I approached it with a very naive set of beliefs. At the time I was young, idealistic entrepreneur. I was not scared that people would steal my ideas, so not entirely stupid, but I feared that a huge company like Microsoft would destroy any startup they put their eyes on. Competition, in my mind, was always won by the party with the biggest firepower. Clayton did a brilliant job of deconstructing this set of beliefs that it managed to convince a silly businessman like me, in this case. The realization that sublime organization is a deterrent to innovation was eye-opening, and it allowed me to focus on doing my thing and worry less about inexistent threats from the sky. We then asked Vladimir, what books had the biggest impact on you? He replied, the funny thing is that the books that had the biggest impact, like my Verne's favorite, are not necessarily the best books, objectively speaking. They were good enough to present a new worldview that I was not aware of. Timing probably was more important than their intrinsic literary qualities. They managed to fall into my lap at the right time. Such a book was Robert Kiyosaki's Rich Dad Poor Dad, a mediocre book by my standards of today, but deeply inspirational by the ones from yesterday. When I read the book, I did not know what an entrepreneur was. I had zero knowledge about money. Granted, the book is quite unsophisticated, but this is what probably made it click for me. It showed me a door that I didn't know existed, and for that I could say it changed my life. We also asked Vladimir, what books would you recommend to youngsters interested in your professional path and why? He answered, I would say there is nothing more inspirational for entrepreneurs or creators out there than Ayn Rand's works. Atlas Shrugged is considered her magnum opus, but I recommend The Fountainhead instead. It condenses most of her philosophy in a shorter book without the intellectual whirlpools Atlas Shrugged is known for. The hero, Howard Roark, is an individualistic young architect who refuses to compromise his artistic and personal vision for success. He chooses to battle the establishment and stand by his values against all odds. The story is simplistic, but it serves as a vessel for communicating liberal values like individualism, private property, innovation, or capitalism, all of which are foundational traits for any creator, entrepreneur or not. Ayn Rand is the journalist's favorite author to hate these days. I am yet to see any serious counter-arguments to her ideology, most articles acting like hit pieces from people who either don't read or didn't understand her books. I would advise to ignore all the nasty reviews and pick her books. We ask Vladimir, we are interested in finding out more about your reading habits. How often do you read and in what format? He replied, I read every day and I rely on all sort of hacks to maximize my learning. I read while I commute, relying on audiobooks from Audible. I read at work, mostly during lunch breaks, and I read when I'm back at home. Apart from my audio, I rely on Kindle for the text part. I still use paper books, but I try to limit this format for the ones with a lot of images. I find visually heavy books impossible to read digitally. Reading for me is the default activity, an activity I fall back on whenever there isn't something more important or urgent to do. We also asked Vladimir, how do you make time for reading? He answered, I don't find it a struggle. It comes naturally to me because I love learning, not because I'm trying to emulate Warren Buffet. I just happen to like reading more than checking my Facebook feed. We also asked Vladimir, do you have a favorite place where you read or you are able to read just anywhere? He replied, I can read anywhere. I'm constantly trying to find new ways to read and learn more. We asked, do you take notes or have any other technique for conquering the torrent of information? Vladimir replied, glad you asked. Yes, I do. I developed quite a complex method of taking and reviewing notes. I wrote a blog post for people interested in my method. I store all my notes in carefully structured OneNote notebooks, and I have weekly review sessions. We then asked, how do you choose what books to read next? He replied, it's all detailed in my post, but to sum it up, I pick my books based on the theme that I'm mostly interested in. For a while, I was into the history of Rome, so I read all the books from my list on that topic. Other times, I was interested in corporate structures, so I read some books on that topic. Usually, my interests are related to some projects I'm considering or working on. We ask Vladimir, do you prioritize those recommended by certain people? Is there anyone that you consider a book recommendations guru? He replied, not really. I try to be very deliberate with my time, and that means that I try to stay away from other people's opinions. I do trust my friends and family, but my interests usually trump other people's reviews. This was our interview with Vladimir Oane. If you want to follow him or find out more about his project, his Twitter account is @VladimirOane. If you check out his website, www.vladimirsays.com, you can find great book recommendations which are available in English. You can find all the books mentioned in this interview in the video description. And don't forget to subscribe to our newsletter at www.theceolibrary.com/newsletter. Thank you!